Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome to this English version of kata Pak Ahmad. Or in English, I would say Pak Ahmad says. So what does Pak Ahmad is going to say this time? Pak Ahmad is going to comment on a video that is going viral in different WhatsApp group. There's a gentleman saying that this mRNA vaccine is actually killing people. It may actually kill people within 2 years. They say that they have some data to back it up. But let's see what this gentleman has to say in this video clip. So allow me to share screen. So here we go.
Protect themselves against what they've already done.
Okay, well, let me correct something that is a part of the disinformation campaign. Everybody has been told that this is an experimental vaccine, that it hasn't been tested and all of that. That's not true. It has been tested. When they tested the mRNA vaccine, so you know, technology, They first tested it in humanized mice. And after 2 months, 100% of the mice had died. They did the same.
So this is interesting. This gentleman mentioned that there's actually the humanized mice. The mRNA vaccine has been tested on humanized mice. The problem is, what is humanized mice? So let me show you an experiment, an important experiment actually in COVID biology. Why is humanized mice an important tool in experiment? So we know that this particle, this virus particle that is found in the human that has COVID, okay, that is found in their lungs. But the question would be whether this particle actually caused the disease. You may have the particle there, you may have the virus there, but the problem is, can you actually prove that this virus actually is causing the disease? So in order to prove it, scientists actually in China, they have done several experiments. They knew from SARS, because SARS and COVID, the causing agents are the same, beta coronavirus. And we know from SARS, the SARS-CoV-1 actually binds to the human ACE2 receptor. So when they look at the genome of the SARS-CoV-1 and SARS-CoV-2, they are quite similar. So they would expect that this virus particle is going to use a human ACE2 receptor. So when they look at the mouse version of ACE2, so this is actually the mouse version. So the mouse version of ACE2, they cannot bind to this SARS-CoV-2, right? Okay, so in order to make an experiment and to prove whether this this virus particle can actually cause a disease, they can create a disease. So they did this experiment. It's published actually very early during the pandemic. It is published in around May 2020, although they submitted for publication to Nature in February. So basically, I myself had read the preprint, and this actually very important data. So if you look at this picture, this is actually the picture of a healthy lung of a mouse. Okay, so this mouse apparently they have been exposed with the SARS-CoV-2, this virus particle, but you can tell. You can tell that this lung is actually quite healthy. So we know that the mouse actually quite resistant to SARS-CoV-2 infection. But if you look at this figure right here, this is actually the picture of a diseased lung. So how come this is a diseased lung? Because this lung belonged to a mouse that has been humanized. What does it mean, a mouse being humanized? So this mouse has been engineered genetically to express a human version of ACE2, right? Okay, so when this engineered mouse, they express the human ACE2, what's going to happen? They actually challenge this mouse with SARS-CoV-2 virus particle. And if you look at the lungs, about 3 days post-infection, the lung is getting infiltrated with leukocytes, and it's getting worse at day 5 post-infection. So this actually mimic quite closely what happened in humans. So the human got pneumonia, so is this mice. So, but with a very important factor, the mouse has to express a human ACE2 receptor. So in this case, we know now that the SARS-CoV-2 virus actually causing the disease was called COVID. They have to actually they prove it in mouse. So in another way, the Koch postulate also is fulfilled in a way. All right. So this mouse that expressed this human ACE2 is a very valuable reagent. It's a very valuable tool. So now scientists can actually ask whether the vaccines they've been developing can actually protect the mouse from the disease. Okay, so let's look at the next things that he has to say, that this mouse actually has been killed, this humanized mouse that actually is killed after about 2 months, right? When they've been exposed to this mRNA vaccine. So is it true? So if you can take a look at this paper, it's an important paper in Nature from a group in Germany. So they've been developing mRNA vaccine, just like what Moderna and Pfizer has developed, okay? And they use this humanized mice as a model, okay? And the target for the vaccine is the spike glycoprotein, okay? It's a spike glycoprotein, which is an important part of the virus to attach to human cells. All right, so now they want to know whether their vaccine, the mRNA vaccine they created, and then they target this spike, can actually protect these humanized mice from SARS-CoV-2 infection, okay? So this is what the data looks like.
And after two...
So they have actually a several group of mice. So the first mice, they're having this in a black symbols, they are the mice that's been treated with sham. Treated with sham meaning that basically they got the same treatment, but they don't get any vaccine. Basically just a regular mice. Of course, these are all the humanized mice. They all express this human ACE2 receptor. Okay, now the mice is labeled blue. They are the ones that have been vaccinated with the inactivated virus. So they took a SARS-CoV-2 virus and then they inactivated. So they give this chemical so the virus cannot replicate. So it will serve as a vaccine with the inactivated platform. And then there's another two groups. So this group of orange group, these are the humanized mice, but this time they have been injected with the mRNA vaccine, the first version and also the second version. So this company actually have two versions of mRNA vaccines. So what happened? So they injected to these mice, these several groups, yeah, there are four groups. So what happens in these four groups? So when the mice not actually injected with any vaccine, there is no antibody being created. So let me put this pointer, so please, it's easier to read. Okay, so apparently this mouse that is injected with, say, placebo or with salt water, and apparently there is no antibody being developed. Now, if you give them this inactivated vaccine, so that the whole virus but they have been inactivated, they do see upregulation of antibody. They see some antibody being induced in this mice. Okay, so sure enough, I mean, this is good. They've been vaccinated. Now, this orange group, they have been vaccinated with this version one of the mRNA vaccine, and it seems to be higher. They have a higher titer of antibody, and so is the other three groups, which are all the green ones, is the second version with different dosage. So you can tell that the antibody actually is being developed. All right, so this mouse developed antibody, and they also look at whether this antibody can neutralize the virus. Okay, so this serum, and then they challenge with the virus in vitro, and then apparently they said they can neutralize the virus. Now, the question is, what happened with this mice, this humanized mice, when they give them mRNA vaccine? So you would expect to see something in this group of mice, the orange group and also the green group. All right, so let's look at the data. So if you look at the data, this is actually a very simple Kaplan-Meier graph. It has two axes. So the x-axis, actually it is the days post-infection. And also you see the y-axis would actually describe the percentage of survival in this group of mice, all right? So you would expect at time zero, all the mice would be survive, okay? All will be alive at time zero. So here actually there are two different graphs. The C graph, actually an experiment using the original variant of the virus that circulated in Germany, because this group is in Germany. And this variant, actually, they take the variant that is circulating at that time in South Africa, or at that time it was called B1351, but now the WHO named it the variant Beta. Okay, so what happened in this experiment? So if you look, remember these all different groups? The black groups, these are the humanized mice that is not given any vaccine, okay? but there have been a challenge with this virus. So what happened is at time zero and also at time 28, all these mice getting this receiving this vaccine except the black group. Okay, the black group doesn't receive any vaccine, just basically salt water. So 4 weeks after this vaccination group, okay, now they challenged with the virus. So this time with the virus, original virus that circulated in Germany at the time, and then this one with the beta variant. So let's look at this this experiment in this set. So in this set, the mice that has not been vaccinated, at day 6 and 8 or day 7, all mice died. Okay, they all died when they're not given any vaccine, remember. So these mice, they're actually being challenged with the original variant of this SARS-CoV-2, right, that circulated in Germany, and they all died at day 7 post-infection. All right, so this is actually the black group. So what happened with the blue group? In the blue group, these mice, they have been vaccinated with inactivated vaccine, okay? So when they give this inactivated vaccine, of course, the antibody actually is shown at day 28 and also at day 55 after being vaccinated, and see whether they can withstand the challenge of this live virus, the original virus that circulated in Germany. And apparently some of them, many of them actually survived day, say day 5, but as the days progress into day 6 and day 8, apparently about 25% died. Okay. Now, interestingly, what happened when they give this mRNA vaccine? So the group has actually two versions. The, again, they're all targeting spike protein, whether this is the orange and also the green. Of course, the green with different dosage. So look at this data. All the mice, when they've been vaccinated with the mRNA vaccine, they survive. Now, they survive against the original variant in Germany. Okay, so what happened when they challenged now with the South Africa vaccine, South Africa variants, yeah, the beta variants or the B1351, excuse me. So this is actually what happened. Those, again, the mice has not been vaccinated, okay? Again, they all died within 10 days, okay? If the mice actually vaccinated with the inactivated form of the vaccine, about 25% died at day 10. Now, interestingly, when they look at the those group of mice, the orange group and the green group, they all survive. So in this case, what the gentleman is saying that the mRNA vaccine actually killing the mice, which is not true, right? Actually, it's the opposite. Those mice that has not been vaccinated and they've been challenged, and they've been exposed to this live virus particles, they do get sick and they died, okay? So, but when they've been protected, when they've been given the vaccine with the mRNA, all of them actually survived. So what the gentleman saying is not correct. It's not based on science. I don't know what kind of data that he has. So that's clearly it is not true. Okay, so that's it for this time. And hopefully we got the right information throughout this pandemic. Be careful of infodemic. And stay safe, everybody. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.